Hard, hard, hard. Nothing but bang. Come on. Up. One more. Last one. Come on. Best rep. Up. Finish, finish, finish. Finish. What's up, guys? Joe Bennett here with Ben Pollack, and we got a leg day today. So for some context for this is that Ben and I have been talking for a year-ish, maybe. Yep. And, you know, he reached out at some point in time, just kind of talking about maybe fine-tuning his training a little bit with the goal of obviously converting over, not completely, but somewhat converting over to the bodybuilding world while still doing a little bit of powerlifting along the way. But his goal now and has been is to turn pro. And so context of right now, I believe you said 8.5 weeks out.
8.5.
Yeah, 8.5 weeks out. Obviously trying to get the pro card. He's got Shelby at the wheel with the diet. So Shelby Starnes doing all of his diet, nutrition, all that good stuff. And so this is the first time we've had the opportunity to train in person, which is nice and which is fun. Because one, I know that Ben knows how to train already. But obviously the way that he trains and the way that I train, which you could make the same statement about anyone on the planet, is always going to be slightly different. So today it was nice because I basically just had a lower body day planned. And I joke, I mean, I love to just train hard. I don't really have like a whole lot of hard set goals, which is tough for me to say as I get older, because I always had that. And now the joke is I just want to be in great shape and I want to train hard. And I want to be able to move with my kids. So again, literally my goal is to be able to train hard. And so it's nice for me to just kind of have the leg day that I planned today. Ben just decided to kind of hop on in and just kind of let me take the wheel and just kind of go through a lower body today. And so we'll probably follow my split for the next 2 weeks or so. Terrence, obviously my other training partner, is just out today. He's kind of on a total body split, just kind of getting himself back in the groove after a little bit of a layoff. So even the split that you guys are going to see, hopefully a couple of videos from the next 2 weeks, will probably change in about 2 weeks as well. And so the nice part is if you look at all of us body part by body part, especially Ben and Terrence have great lower body, great backs. I've got an okay back. But again, my stuff doesn't matter. But the thing that both of them kind of need to bring up a little bit is just extremities, arms and delts. And then everything else can just kind of keep on growing. I mean, so even from Terrence, even with having a weight cap and having to cut down 5 or 6 pounds to make his weight cap, we can still always add a little bit of tissue here and there. So, you know, a little bit more tissue going on the legs and back is never a bad thing. And then, like I said, just bringing up the priority body parts. So for today's leg workout, we just been starting, because again, a lot of this was revolved around Terrence, starting a little bit more posterior chain dominant. So starting with a deadlift variation. I like the bands on this one. I make the argument for efficiency, but also kind of secondarily, as opposed to banding across the hip, which might be actually more challenging from a glute hamstring standpoint, I like to actually load the upper back a little bit on this as well too. So the main mover, of course, is going to be hams and glutes. But again, just literally holding 100 plus pounds more than is on the bar at the top, I think is a great way to get a little bit of extra upper back trap work in there as well too. So starting with RDLs, moving into seated leg curls, my favorite hamstring movement, isolated hamstring movement, because I would just make the argument it takes the most stability out of it, allows just the most direct work of the hamstring, and loads them where they're the strongest. So the strongest through that lengthened position, right through about the near mid-range. And then we both got our ass kicked on the pendulum. That's probably my third go on that pendulum, which is one of my favorite, if not my favorite, pendulum squats ever made. And it's just brutal. So again, I've talked about that kind of for a while as well too. Just a very, very good profile. Lighter at the bottom, heavier at the top. Matches what your body can do, which just makes every single rep, especially the failure reps, extra horrible. Then we did some lying leg curls. Then we did some split squats. And then we finished with some prowler stuff. Which now I say, it sounds kind of like a lot, but it was good. And to get, for the context on that, we end up, I pretty much always only do one working set on the RDLs just because it's an extremely taxing movement. So it's because it's a bigger muscle that's responsible for a relatively large range of motion. The bar is going to move through a lot of space, will travel a lot of distance. And with the bands, it's just very, very efficient. So I'd make the argument efficient and taxing go hand in hand. It's a lot to recover from. So one set seems to get the job done very well. And then the same on squats. I've been doing one set basically working thing for the squats. Again, just because it's a big movement, great profile, very efficient, very taxing. Probably in the next week or two, I'll add a back off set in there as well too. And then again, I always listen to my knee was a little bit funky today, which just happens every once in a while. So I always listen to that as well too. Beforehand, I was thinking about maybe doing an extra set, but it just didn't feel great coming off of that. And same with Ben, his knees are going to be trashed at some point in time as well too. So we make the joke, you know, you lift heavy enough, and obviously he lifts a lot heavier than I do more frequently. And just the volume that will come with the bodybuilding world, it's not the best thing if you want to have, you know, immaculate orthopedic health at 92 years old or something. So that's, again, a whole argument for efficiency, doing as little as possible to produce maximal results. But overall, really, really good session. Again, pretty much training the entire lower body completely. And again, I just like incorporating a little bit of stuff like the split squats because I think there's some unique stuff you get with that back leg position as well as doing single leg stuff. And I love the Prowler for just a little extra volume or pump work. I'd make the argument it's the most efficient pump work you can get because it's only concentrics. There's no eccentrics. So very, very easy on recovery and just turns about as much metabolic byproduct as you can have in a short period of time. And it's good to work on the gas tank. I still feel like I'm not quite back to the best shape that I've been in. And so again, that helps me get there a little bit quicker as well too. Anything you want to add? Or?
Yeah, well, I do. I mean, I really want to thank you for letting me come and train with
for
you.
Sure, man.
I mean, you talked about how your goal is to be able to train hard and keep up with your kids and all. When I'm done competing, my goal is to be the best strength coach I can possibly be. And from in my opinion, in order to do that, I need to know more than just strength. I need to know the bodybuilding side. I need to know the strongman side, the diet side, whatever the case may be. So being able to have the opportunity to learn from you really does mean a lot to me. And you also mentioned, like, the primary goal right now, obviously, is the pro card, but powerlifting is always going to be number one in my heart. And so to be able to learn a lot, and you guys will see as we go through the video, being able to learn where my weaknesses in powerlifting might have been overlooked when I'm just doing the squat, bench, and deadlift that are really brought out with some of these isolation exercises, that is really fun and exciting for me. So you guys will see when we're doing the leg curls, I have really, really weak ranges of motion at the very beginning and very end, so much so that, you know, Joe's doing twice as much weight as I am. But, you know, that's eye-opening and exciting for me. I know if I strengthen those weak ranges of motion, not only am I going to have much better hamstrings, I'm going to have much better deadlift. I'm going to feel much more comfortable in the hole in the squat. Same thing with the pendulum squat, you know, coming out of the hole there where it's really all focused on that knee teardrop on that knee extension. That's really going to help me have that strength, that comfort in the hole, even without knee wraps, which I tend to rely on for powerlifting. So all that is really, really exciting to me. And then obviously getting a brutal workout in is always awesome. So yeah, it was a great day. I'm really, really grateful that I had the opportunity.
Yeah, glad to have you, man. Yeah, it was a great session. I always say that as well, too. If it wasn't a great session, I'd be like, well, see you later, but it was good. I'll touch base next week. But no, it was a great session on my end as well, too, which is nice. I joke, too, it's like half of it is I always want hard sessions. I'm also at a point in time, one, where it's like I'm not ever really intentionally trying to run anyone into the ground. If I don't like somebody, maybe every once in a while. But for the most part, you know, the goal is to obviously have hard sessions on both ends. So it's nice for me to have what I consider a hard session as well too. Feel like appropriately kind of put it on Ben a little bit as well. But again, not just to do stupid stuff. If I really wanted to make somebody die, I'd be like, all right, we're just going to put 25s on the pendulum and just do a 400 rep drop set, which is not, there's no challenge in that. And there's not really any purpose for that either, aside from maybe laughing at someone.
This was very clearly effective hard training, right? Like very, very clearly. I like that.
Yeah. So anyway, first leg day in the books, we're going to have a lot more coming for you guys. So, yeah, I forgot to say in the beginning, don't forget to do that whole YouTube thing. Like, subscribe, tell a reasonable amount of friends, 18, 1900 people would be good. And until the next one, guys.
Yes! That's enough!
Stick with it. Hams. There we go. Best rep. Up. Finish. There you go.
Safe. Don't cut that out.